الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله ذي الفضل والكرم الحمد لله ذي القدرة والنعم الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون Oh, you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared and die not except on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya arhamar rahimeen. Amma ba'd. We narrated the story about a lady from Al-Basra, from Al-Salaf Al-Salih, from the righteous predecessors. She was, subhanAllah, every time she was facing a big calamity or difficulties in her life, it's been always seen on her the sign of serenity, the sign of a glowing face and beautiful patience. And she's been asked about the secret of that. She said, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, every time I face a big difficulty, I remember the greatest of the difficulty. I remember the most terrifying of the difficulties. It is hellfire. Then when I imagine how big and tremendous that calamity, I will feel any other difficulty tiny. The difficulty of dunya, it will wear out. The difficulty of dunya is going to come ease after it. But the difficulty of the akhirah doesn't have solution, doesn't have an outcome. And this is, someone when he reflect on this saying of this righteous lady, he think in himself, how did they have this iman? How they have this iman to refresh our iman, to think like they do think. It is, ikhwani, the first item in the belief. The first element when you read the beginning of the Qur'an in the belief of the unseen. Is to believe in the unseen. But the belief in the unseen, and in a way to believe in it as a core belief, you do not interact with it. Or a belief that you like to try to live the moment of the unseen. To imagine the moment of the unseen. To see how in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us realities, He tells you don't have any way to conceive it or to understand it, but just listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you a reality that is going to live yourself. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us is very terrifying moment and a very difficult moment that we need to remind ourselves. The reminder. It really benefit the believers. Those who prostrate to Allah, those who are in sujood, those who are in dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remind them to keep them back and have them to be holding tight to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول رب العزة سبحانه وتعالى في سورة مريم وإن منكم إلا والدها كان على ربك حتما مقضيا. Every one of you is going to go to hellfire. Every one of you is going to go to hellfire, but he's going to pass over hellfire. وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَرِدْهُ Every single one of you. Now when we're thinking about this lady, and many of the story of the Salaf, when he read this ayah, it's a reality. He's like someone traveling, say, be careful, there's a bridge broken, so you need to find a way, if not you're going to stuck at the road, you cannot pass. So you'll plan for it. You're going to plan, you found another route in anything. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَرِدْوَ Every one of you is going to get into it. And the amazing thing, Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he brought some evidence in the Quran. He said, وَرَدَ أَيْدَخَلَ He want to enter, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ Now, in reality, if how to bring this ayah, to imagine it and to live this ayah. As Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah mentioned in the book of al-Tafkir, he said, if you are standing, imagine yourself, and it's going to come to the moment. It's going to come with no doubt. That's the belief of the unseen. That's what I meant by not called believing unseen. You interact, you believe something is going to happen. You plan for it like your travel. You check the weather, you check things. This is the belief in the unseen. You're going to be standing in front of al-Sirat. Al-Sirat, what is al-Sirat? كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قيل وما الجسر يا رسول الله قالوا دحض مزلة something that you fall into and a trip and someone can slide into hellfire والعياذ بالله because الجسر is above the hellfire and is thin as a hair and is sharp as a blade. How can someone can be passing that with no problem? He needs some training. Then someone, if he's standing, subhanAllah, at that moment, and imagine yourself. Let's make a way of imagining ourselves. This is the belief in the unseen. You are in a state of in the hereafter in front of the Sirat. You cross the Sirat, you get to the mercy of Allah. Between you and paradise is this bridge, is this Sirat. If you cross it, you'll be there. Ya Allah, if you cross it, you'll be in the rahm of Allah. Just cross it, but how are you going to cross it? Because you're going to see how the Prophet ﷺ قال كلاليب ومخاطيف وحسك. It's going to be like claws of iron, and it's like a pliers and hooks taking people, get them down to hellfire. And someone, he feel like so tiny because he's so huge hellfire, and he's so dark, the flame of it is dark, and he hear the mourning of hellfire, he's so terrifying, almost bursting. He's going to burst from anger. And you are standing. When this is reality, we're going to see this. You're standing, you're going to cross. Seeing all this, the angels taking people in hellfire, other being their skin is being ripped, other they're flying, other they're passing so fast. And you are wondering how you're going to pass. When you, alhamdulillah, we are still in the dunya, you're going to have three things. At that situation, you are fearing to fall into hellfire. And you are hoping to get to paradise. And you want to do it as fast as possible. At that moment, you're going to be, wal-iyadu billah, from those, when you see that moment, يوم يعض الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. He knows that he cannot do it. He going to bite on his hand. Allah didn't say fingers, hands. يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولْ I wish I would have taken with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the way that I followed the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. Woe to me, I wish I didn't take that person to be my friend who misled me from the path of Allah. لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. He really did make me, led me astray after reminder of Quran that we have in our pocket, we have in our devices, we have it everywhere. أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. He misled me, he pushed me away. But no regret, it doesn't work at that time. Then someone in the situation, imagine he cannot cross. He cannot cross because he's going to fall into hellfire. Or you'll be from those, inshallah, all of us. You'll be from those, you'll make a sincere tawbah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept you. يَوْمَ لَا يُخْزِي اللَّهُ النَّبِيَّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. At the day Allah will not disgrace the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and whoever followed him with ihsan and whoever believer who followed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with ihsan. نُورُهُمْ يَسْعَ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهُ. You see, your light is going to be your light. You see, this darkness is not going to be darkness because hellfire is going to tell you, please pass, your light is going to extinguish my fire. I want you to pass so fast. Why? Because you have the light of Allah, the light that is the marks of your wudu that you do today, the marks of your dhikr, the marks of your action, the marks of your sujood. All the marks is going to be light. نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون. All in group you will be in zumar, in groups you will be shouting all together, ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا
You'll be screaming, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbana, fulfill our nur, make our light to be gone farther and farther and greater to be in the Jannah. Waqfil lana. Oh Allah, forgive us. You have the power to do it, Ya Allah. Innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. At that moment, you are standing and you wish. But at that moment, you cannot wish because it's been already done. But we want to be from those who will be with the Prophet. We want to be Rabbana. أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا يا ربنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. We want to be from those people. And if you want to work for it, if you really fear that hellfire at that moment, the fear that you have today is going to be the mirror, the reflection of the fear over there. The way you live today, that's how the way you're going to cross the Sirat is exactly the same. It's a copy, it's a reflection. Inna kunna nastansikhu ma kanu ya'malu. We've been to copy everything what they used to do. Therefore, the way you acted today is the way that how you're going to cross. The way someone is praying, that the way that he's going to be on the Sirat, it's exactly the same. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامِ الْعَبِيدِ. People, they take training for months and years to get in shape for a game. Why? Because they want to do it in the right and the greatest performance possible. If you have a path as sharp as a blade and as thin as a hair, you will be, need to be trained. You need maybe to pass, like the Prophet ﷺ said, like the blink of an eye, or you'll be passing like al-barq, like the thunder, or you'll be passing like flying, like a tayr, or be passing like you are riding a horse. كجياد الخيل كما قال المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because there will be three categories. قال فمسلم ناج فناج مسلم ومخدوش مرسل ومكدوس في النار. Three categories. People, they're going to be saved. Others, they're going to be ripped. Subhanallah. That they're going to be thrown to be saved in the air. Crawling and fighting and striving and trying to avoid these hooks. And others, they're going to be falling in hellfire. But you want to go straight. How to go straight? Your way of life today is the reflection, the copy, how you want to do it. You fear and you hope. What is your fear today? Check your fear in seven things. Check your fear of Allah in your tongue. Lying, gossiping, backbiting, or dhikr of Allah. Check your fear in your heart. Envy, desire, longing for accumulation, or dhikr and love of Allah and His Messenger and striving in His sake. Check the fear into your eyes, in your gaze. Are you from those who really looking forward to look at the Quran, to look at the Kaaba, to look at the thing that really increase your iman? Or for those who do not have any haya, any shyness from Allah, to look at everything that caused the wrath of Allah. Check the fear of Allah in your hand. Every time you stretch your hand, you stretch it for the halal or you stretch it for the haram. Check the fear of Allah in your legs. Are you using these legs to take you to what caused the wrath of Allah? Or using your legs for those or the places that help you to be into the safety and the blessing of Allah? Check all of that. These are five and the seventh or sixth. The seventh one, check, ikhwani, your obedience. The life of your obedience to Allah. It is sincere or just someone want to take care or to get rid of a burden. Check if it is for the sake of Allah or to someone he's showing off. The fear of Allah, ya akhwani, it's not something that you're being scared so you want to run from it because we are threatened. The fear of Allah is an order from Allah. فَإِيَّايَ فَرْهَبُونَ وَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونَ is an order, is a way of worship. Because when you fear anyone else, you run from him. But when you fear Allah, you run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to stand the whole night praying. And when he came in Surah Al-Muddathir, قال إِنَّ لَدَيْنَا أَنْكَالًا وَجَحِيمًا وَطَعَامًا ذَا غُصَّةٍ وَعَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. As it's been narrated in Al-Bayhaqi, we have this change. We have وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ the jahim, this hellfire. We have this food that caused someone to choke. We have all these burning things that someone cannot even imagine, and he doesn't want even to remember. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sa'aq, as he said in Al-Bayhaqi, he fainted from the fear of Allah.
وَعُمَرْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ In the time of the Ummah, when everyone used to recite the Qur'an, in the time when you find someone standing, reciting, and the other one crossing his leg, reciting during the night, in the time when you go make a round in Al-Madinah, you feel like the sound of bees, everyone is reading the Qur'an. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu passing by, riding, and he heard someone reading, وَالطُّورُ وَكِتَابٍ مَسْطُورٍ فِي رَقٍ مَنْشُورٍ وَالْبَيْتِ الْمَعْمُورِ وَالسَّقْفِ الْمَرْفُوعِ وَالْبَحْرِ الْمَسْجُورِ إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّكَ لَوَاقَى. The punishment of Allah is going to occur, to happen with no doubt. وَقَعَ is going to fall. وَقَعَ, it hit Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he fell from his right. He fell from the donkey he was riding, he fell on the ground. وَقَعَ مَا لَهُ مِنْ دَافِعٍ, no one can stop it. This is the Qur'an, if you taste it, it doesn't require a depth of the knowledge or reading of tons of book. Just imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you facts, describing for us, is like you watch a scene, like you watch a movie. If you just reflect and just be in that moment, your iman will have a rush. You will be from the highest ranked in iman. Thus, when we read about the Salaf, we'll be amazed how this has happened, because they used to imagine it's like we're trying today standing. We didn't yet cross. You're still thinking how we're going to do it. Do you have the right fear in the dunya to help you, and the right hope that you're longing to Allah? Do you have that race for the good? Do you have that when you go to sleep to wake up and the time to pray Fajr? That is what is going to reflect into your way of crossing. If you do not make the right prayer, you're going to trip. If you do not pray, you're going to slide. If you run to the prayer, you're going to run onto the Sirat. If you are asked to help and you run over the Sirat. If you are asked to help and you'll be stingy, you're going to trip and slide in the Sirat. That's the balance. That's the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jibreel alayhi salam. One of the things, ikhwani, is like when you are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, is the great fear that you have is not fear that to break you, make you lose hope, is a fear that increases your hope. Jibreel alayhi salam, learning from the Quran that he's been blessed. Jibreel alayhi salam fearing himself the wrath of Allah. Is not the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa describing the state of Jibreel in Al-Mi'raj. He was like alayhi salam shaking like a pale, like a very worn out rag of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa describing. And when you do the fear of Allah, when you live the fear of Allah, Allah will give you the glad tidings. He will have on your face this bliss, this glowing of the face, the contentment in the heart. Jibreel alayhi salam, he the one when he revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Surah Al-Takwir, he realized how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala esteem and appreciate Jibreel. That was one of the great happiness for Jibreel alayhi salam. When he said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولٍ كَرِيمٍ. This is the saying of most honorable messenger in Jibreel. Jibreel, he's listening to the revelation he's taken to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about his importance. It's like you're working so hard and you are so dedicated in your work, you don't look, you're looking forward to be thanked.
But when thanks comes from a very important or from the highest or the owner of the corporate, of the king of the town, when he sends you a special thank, you'll be so overwhelmed. That's Jibreel alayhi salam, how he felt. قال إنه لقول رسول كريم ذي قوة عند ذي العرش مكين. Allah complimenting Jibreel, the one with strength and the one who he has a high rank in the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ. He's fully obeyed by the angels and he's trustworthy. That was the great rahmah from Jibreel. To tell you, the great rahmah in the Quran is for us. If you just taste the Quran, if you just imagine yourself, if you open the book today, and you imagine yourself to cross the Sirat, it's going to be a totally different reading. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَعِيمٍ أَخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُحْسِنِينَ. Those muttaqeen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were good doers. Stop there. I want to be like them. كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَجْعَوْنَ. They used to pray the night. You ask, how can I do that? It is when you imagine that you're going to be really there. Then you're going to prepare for it. Like you're preparing for a trip tomorrow, you're going to prepare everything. That's how the believer will prepare himself from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaj'alna min al-muttaqin. Yahya ibn Mu'adh, he used to say this. And I want you to reflect. Qala miskinun ibn Adam. Miskin. Poor is the son of Adam. If he'll fear hellfire as he fears poverty, he will be in paradise. If he fears hellfire as he fears poverty, he will be in paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the fear of Allah the greatest in our heart, and the hope also the greatest of our heart. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَغَفُورُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى. Dear brother and respected sister, our gathering in the hereafter is amrun maqdi, something being ordained. And our passing through the sirat is being decreed already. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, after he said everyone is going to go through it, قَالَ ثُمَّ نُنَجِّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوا. Then we will save those righteous, al-muttaqoon, which is mean our goal to be min al-muttaqeen. That's our goal. Now the taqwa, it comes with the fear and hope and the way you live your life, how motivated you are. The taqwa is going to decide of how fast you cross the sirat. High level of taqwa, faster you'll be. Less, the slowest you be, the slower you be. We'll give an example, an easy example. When you come to the masjid, there's people from the morning, they are already planning to come. There's people that come before the salah, and they stay making dhikr. There's people that come at the time of the salah. There's people that come and they miss the takbiratul ihram. Other, they join in the end of the salah. Other, they come after the salah. Other, they don't even come. This group, every one of them is going to have different speed crossing the path. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. You come first and you have more motivation for the sake of Allah, the more speed you gain in crossing the sirat. It's a simple equation. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be the fastest. What he said? سَابِقُوا وَسَابِقُوا. Compete and race for the forgiveness. The more you compete, the more you have the motivation, the more you'll have a speed to cross it. And just the crossing, what behind it? There's a bridge. A bridge where you're going to cleanse yourself if you have a problem with different brothers and sisters. And then you enter paradise. But if someone, subhanAllah, will fall in hellfire, we don't want to do that. We don't want it either. But it happened for some people, there will be. And one of them for 1,000 years, he's screaming, Ya Hannan, Ya Manna. He's in hellfire. And he's screaming, Ya Hannan, Ya Manna. The most kind, the most one who gift and shower his servant with man and ihsan. After 1,000 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered to the angel, he said, get him out, ask him why he's calling, and Allah already knows. He said, I'm calling because I know that in hellfire by the justice of Allah, I only blame myself. But I never give up hope on the rahmah of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entered him in paradise. He said, as you came out, you're not going to get back there. You go to my rahmah. And today we are together. We call, Ya Allah, Ya Hannan, Ya Mannan. Allahumma Ya Hannan, Ya Mannan. أدخلنا جنتك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم يا حنان يا منان اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين اللهم يا حنان يا منان وطد خوفك في قلوبنا ورجاءك في أنفسنا يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. Dear brother, we have a dear brother who has lost one of his member of the family. We'll make dua for him and for those who passed away. And akhani, this is the truth. Al-mawtu haqq. Our life is illusion without the akhirah. Al-mawtu haqq. This brother, he made his departure. And everyone is going to do. Today we say about him, Rahimahullah. Tomorrow, they're going to say about us, Inshallah, Rahimahullah. May Allah to have people to make dua for us. And we want to do it for those who passed away for this brother. Allahumma taqabbalhu bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma akrim nuzulahum wa wassa' mudkhalahum. Allahumma ighfir lahum ajma'in. Allahumma naqihim min khatayahum kama yunqa thawb al-abyad min ad-danas. Allahumma ighsilhum min khatayahum bil-thalj wal-ma'i wal-barad bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Ya akrim al-akramin wa akhir da'wana ان الحمد لله رب العالمين واقم الصلاه يرحمكم الله